Hello, scientists. I'm Professor Bill Tyson, and together we're gonna know different from the science. Today, we'll learn about something very big and important, but very small in size. I'm talking about the atom. Thousands of years ago, in a country called Greece, a philosopher named Leucippus and his disciple, Democritus, thought, what would happen if I broke a stone until it reached the point where it could no longer be broken? And it was then that they imagined a piece that it couldn't be divided. And that was when the name atom came up, which means undivisible. A long time passed, and a chemist named John Dalton, who through various researches saw that Leucippus and Democritus were right, that the atom was really small, and until then, indivisible. And he created a model in which the atom was a tiny solid ball. More than 100 years later, the English physicist Joseph Thomson discovered a small part of the atom, or the electron. Thomson presented a new model of atom, where it wasn't a solid, but composed of two particles. The electrons would stay inside a large particle. This atomic model became known as raisin pudding. In 1911, scientists Ernest Rutherford and Niels Bohr, based on new studies, presented a new atomic model, in what particles called protons are in the center, along with other particles, which would later be called neutrons. These two particles form what we call nucleus of the atom. And the electrons, much smaller, move very fast, making circles around the nucleus. I think it's better clean this place, because the only particles I see are these up dust. Ooh. That's it for now. See you next time! Hey guys, show a little scientist that studying science can be fun. Share this video and become my patron.